overhand strike coming. I want to see how fast you can block it. Pay attention to what I'm doing here, because I want to show you how to double your speed. Now, listen to what I'm saying. I don't think that there's a black belt out there who, if you didn't work on your timing speed, your miles per hour speed, and your initial speed, that it isn't possible for anybody out there to double your speed. Now, watch this little trick here. Position. Okay. As soon as you see me coming, let's see how fast you can block. Okay. Now, notice. I've got about 4 feet to go to get your face. You've got about 4 inches to go to block my hand. Okay? Let's see what happens now. You got to be quick. Let's try it again now. You got to be fast. You got a fight coming up next week. See? Position. It's my sparring partner. I can talk to him like that. Let's try it again. You got to be quick now. Let's try it here. Not a black belt, but a professional fighter. Been a black belt for a long time. I'm telling him what's coming. I'm allowing him to get set. He's only got to move his hand 4 inches. Now, when you folks try this at home, keep this in mind. When you make that block, instead of utilizing a traditional block, which is moving with the elbow, everybody see my whole elbow is moving? That's too slow. Just move this part of your arm from your elbow to your fist. So you just have part of your arm. And then cut it down to just the wrist move. Does everybody see the wrist moving? So just the wrist moves and the elbow moves slightly. So that's a much quicker block. That type of block. That's one little secret to help you block it. For a while, I was able to get that punch in on Bruce Lee, but he would always go into that little Zen alpha state, and then you couldn't get anything through. You probably couldn't even hit him with a bullet. He was so fast. All right. Now, let me show you.